Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Hania from the Teal Tajin, and today I'm coming to you with a quick tip on how to clean and how to use fava beans. So as you can see here, I have some whole fava beans and some fava beans that I've already cleaned, and I have some pods right here. So the fava beans usually grow on a bush, and they're in season here in northern Africa and Algeria in the fall, winter, and all the way to the spring. So they're only not available in the summertime. So there's different sizes of fava beans depending on how mature you have the bean. So the most mature would be like this pod here. This is the most mature. So if we just snap off the end here and pull back the membrane, there's this back membrane here that we can just pull right off here, much like a green bean. We open the pod up, and then we see the pods are all in here. They're attached by this little ear, much like any other bean that you would buy or grow. And the mature beans look pretty much like this. Then they have this little brown slit there. And younger beans would be like this. Just open that one up. As you can see, they're quite smaller and lighter in color. And then there's even smaller ones such as these here. So what I like to do when I clean my fava beans is come, and there's this little membrane here that we can pull back simply just like that, and then we expose the beans as I showed you earlier, and then we have the beans inside. So we can just take the beans out one by one, or you can take them all out at the same time. They usually come with an ear. This ear attaches the bean to the pod. And I like to take that off because when you cook it, it usually does come off. So you don't want those extra pieces in your soup, stew, or any dish that you're making. So an extra tip for you is that when you work with fava beans, you do want to take a knife, such as this one, a paring knife or even a needle, and give it a little prick or a little slit there, and this will help the fava beans cook completely inside and not only on the outside, because many times when you cook with fava beans, this outer skin gets cooked but the inside is raw. So if we open the fava beans itself just like this, there is the inside bean. This is the tender part. In most Western cooking, and even in several Tunisian dishes, they only use the inside. So as you can see, the bean is like this. You can cut it in half, and it comes in half like this. So they would either steam this or saute it in some butter and make it into a quick, nice salad. Just to also note, as you can see, my fingers are a little bit brown or black, and this is from the cleaning of the fava beans. The fava beans do stain your fingers, so even though I would suggest cleaning your hands a little bit, rubbing some lemon on your hands, similarly like when you are cleaning artichokes, the brown and the black will stain your fingers and your hands, and there's really nothing you can do about it, and you'll just have to be patient and let it. There are some dishes here in Algeria which actually do use the whole pod. There's one dish called the Rose Bretel, which is from the city of Constantine. They would use a smaller, younger bean such as this, not the one like this. This is quite a mature one. You see it's even getting brown. This would be too mature. So they would use this type of bean in this dish called Rose Bretel. So simply all they would do for that dish is cut the ends off, such as this, so cut the ends, and then cut it into bite-sized pieces as this. And then they would use parts like this and cooked into a piquant, sometimes spicy red sauce, which they do call Rose Bretel. Another way that you can use fava beans are in couscous. There's many dishes that use couscous. You can use the couscous, the beans such as this, the fava beans, in couscous dishes that have vegetables, or even just the mesfouf style of couscous where they just steam the couscous and mix it with either steamed dried fruits or some vegetables such as this. So for a recipe on how to use the fava beans and couscous. You can find that linked below in the comment box below, or you can find it also in the cards here in the corner. You can also use these fava beans in dishes such as the tabeja, which I'm going to do a video on in the near future, inshallah. And as far as other dishes, there's an Egyptian dish which they also make in many parts of the Middle East. It's called ful mudammas, and they usually make this with dried fava beans, but you can also make that with fresh fava beans such as I'm using here. Inshallah, I'm going to make a video about that in the near future as well. In Tunisia, they also make a simple fava bean stew or salad, you could call it, where they do take, as I showed the example, they take the outer skin off of the fava bean. They take this outer skin off here, and they just use the tender part here where they steam it and then saute in butter, mix it with some spices such as ground coriander, cinnamon, harissa, and ground cumin, and it's a simple side salad for any dish or meal that you have. Inshallah, I hope you like this tip video about how to clean and how to use fava beans. Inshallah, it will encourage you to buy some fava beans in your local market and try new dishes with the fava beans or broad beans or horse beans, depending on where you live and how they're called. Until next time, peace be upon you, and salamu alaikum.